The Asiatic elephant is the largest living land animal in Asia and an emblem of many cultures on the continent. Now listed as an endangered species by the International Union for the Conservation of Nature, their numbers have declined by over 50% in three generations as a consequence of habitat loss and poaching. Yet in order to entertain tourists, this magnificent species is still widely exploited across India, Burma, and Thailand. In order for Asian elephants to be trained to perform stunts, they undergo a brutal breaking in process. It causes the painful death for up to 2/3 of baby elephants. The UK charity Save the Asian Elephants is now proposing to the British government legislation to ban tour operators from promoting elephant attractions. I spoke with animal rights campaigner and father to the Prime Minister, Stanley Johnson, who supports the campaign. Stanley, thank you for joining us on Planet SOS. How did you first get involved in campaigning for Asian elephants?
Well, I suppose Asian elephants have always been, as it were, less on people's horizon than African elephants. I mean, obviously, they're smaller on the one hand, and they're smaller in terms of their numbers. I mean, when I first started thinking about African elephants, there were several million of them. Now we're down, you know, to a few hundred thousand. But as far as Asian elephants are concerned, you know, we're down to, I don't know what it is, 20,000, 50,000, something like that. I think it was really also because I met up with Duncan McNair, who was absolutely passionate about what was happening to Asian elephants, not just in terms of their environmental status, their conservation status, but also in terms of the sheer unimaginable cruelty which they were subjected to. This cruelty, I didn't go into it too much here, but the young elephants were taken from the wild. They were subjected to a form of discipline called pajan, beaten, terrorized, and eventually, taken to serve in temples or in wildlife parks or in elephant camps, elephant rides. And Duncan really persuaded me to join him in setting up an organization called Save the Asian Elephant. And that is campaigning in a fairly directed way, really. It's campaigning to achieve a ban on British tourists going to sites in Asia, and of course many of them are in India, but some are in Thailand and in other countries which have Asian elephants, going to those sites and, as it were, quote unquote, enjoying the exploitation of this poor animal, whether it's through elephant rides or through elephant displays of one kind or another. And that's what he's trying to do.
Do you think tourists are actually aware of the abuse that happens behind the scenes in elephant attractions?
I suspect that some people may, you know, in the back of their minds, have an inkling, would put that back of their minds inkling out. For example, you know, we all of us know the link between palm oil and the plight of the orangutan. But I guess there's a time when you buy your Mars bar and you kind of put out of your mind that Mars bar contains palm oil. Yeah, so it is a double-edged process. I think there's a direct legislative measure which can and should be introduced. And I think also there's, of course, the educational aspect, which is fundamental too.
Stanley, we've all been living through this coronavirus lockdown across the world. Do you think that it could actually be a catalyst to change human relationships with the environment and nature?
Well, I don't want to say I told you so, but 40 years ago, I wrote a book called The Virus, which had just been republished. And that indeed is based on the thought that you can take animals from the wild, you can treat them, you can release all kinds of diseases, which you then have to deal with. And this is absolutely crucial. Of course, the search for the vaccine is crucial. I'd make one extra thought, which didn't occur to me when I wrote that book 40 years ago, and that is the dangers of the route of intensive farming, which we are now going down so fast and so far. that has to be a key priority now, to look at the dangers in that.
Stanley Johnson, thank you for joining us on Planet SOS. For nearly all captive elephants, life involves pain, fear, dehydration, malnutrition, and suffering. A horrific ordeal for a highly intelligent animal, which shares traits with humans and apes, such as grief, compassion, and self-awareness. Duncan McNair is leading the campaign for new legislation to ban tour operators promoting elephant attractions.
I'm the CEO of Save the Asian Elephants, and our purpose is the preservation and protection of the fast dwindling and critically endangered Asian elephants, whose numbers have absolutely crashed in the last century, particularly the last 20 years or so. The use of elephants, Asian elephants, in tourism is absolutely widespread across Southeast Asia, and it is continuing relentlessly. Stay has no problem with elephant tourism, but we have every problem with the vast majority of it, which is very brutal. And people don't always realize, James, that to ride an elephant or to wash it or to have a selfie with it, any of those activities, any direct contact, involves the most extreme brutality to the elephant, usually as a baby, snatched illegally from the wild, its mother killed in front of it, who tries to protect it, and then it is isolated, starved, stabbed, beaten, ripped with hooks to break its spirit, Bajan as it's known, to make it easily compliable in tourism. That's the only way, because elephants are wild animals. You couldn't jump on the back of a wild lion without consequences, and likewise an elephant. And so we have everything against that. It is often referred to as the most awful and extreme animal cruelty in the world. Even if we take stock now, what Stay has done is this. We've looked at 650 companies, pretty much at random, who advertise these elephant-related holidays in Southeast Asia. Of those, we find that 75%, just under 500, are advertising what we call UEVs, unethical elephant venues. That's where all sorts of unnatural activities are forced upon the elephants by the most extreme brutality. Of those, a large minority, in the order of 25%, are ABTA members. And I return again to ABTA because not only are they dominant in the UK market as the commercial trade representative of the large major part of the travel industry, but because they have been pressing government about, they've been having a series of meetings and communications with government throughout this year. They've not admitted that to us, but government have done so in a parliamentary answer earlier this year. So ABTA, who appear possibly to have the ear of government, whilst ignoring us, are, we fear, trying very hard to influence and to try to maintain this grotesque status quo. The travel industry has shown again and again it is not prepared to put an end to this itself. Most people say that self-regulation, marking your own homework, in other words, is futile and absurd, and it must now be replaced by proper law.
I talked to the travel association ABTA about their policies towards animal welfare and Asian elephants.
Animal attractions and experiences are a common part of many holidays, but whilst they're popular, customers want to be assured of good animal welfare standards. And so this is why we developed animal welfare guidelines. We actually list elephant contact without a barrier. So this includes things like riding or bathing, and also elephant shows as unacceptable. As the evidence provided suggested, it was possible to transition to a model of viewing elephants from a respectful distance and meet high standards of animal welfare. In terms of our members, in actual fact, the vast majority of our members have moved away from selling unacceptable elephant practices or are working with their suppliers to move away from these practices.
Animal exploitation to entertain people at zoos and circuses has existed for centuries. But the rise in social media has seen an increased demand for selfies and unique experiences with exotic wildlife. Legislation in the UK to ban the advertising of Asian elephant attractions may well reduce the demand amongst the British public. But ultimately, this is an international issue. And it's only when tourists everywhere turn their back on these activities and Asian governments themselves ban these operations that cruelty towards the Asian elephants will stop.